Who's heard of ChatGPT? Who am I kidding? Of course you have. ChatGPT is just the beginning, and artificial intelligence is having a radical effect on how many businesses operate on a day-to-day basis. Rather than just asking about tonight's dinner recipe, let's take a look at how you can leverage this powerful tool for the benefit of your own business using Continuum's world-first Alteryx ChatGPT connector. Here I am in Alteryx, and I've got a workflow loaded up. I'm gonna run through a really nice, simple to understand example with you right now. Let's say that I'm a retail business and I'm reselling some laptops, for example. Selling so many laptops, in fact, that I've got tons of reviews on my website. Now, it's just not scalable to have someone read through all of those reviews individually and say, was it positive or was it negative? And if it was either, which were the influencing factors that made it positive or negative? So what we're going to do is utilize the reviews, which you can see visualized down here in my results grid that are coming from my website, and we're going to place these into ChatGPT through our world-first Alteryx connector and actually get ChatGPT to grade the sentiment for us and pick out the phrases that influence that grade. The way that we've done this is actually got a couple of instructions coming down here from my text input tool. If I expand this out somewhat, what I can see is that my prompts say, provide me with an integer numeric score between 1 and 10. So that 1's going to be super negative, they're not happy. 10, very positive. Okay, we're doing something right with this customer. However, we don't just want that scale, that score. What we're interested in is actually a short capitalized comma-separated list of the laptop attributes that were mentioned, right? This is the very important part of when you're interacting with your data and ChatGPT. You need to make sure that the prompt you're providing GPT is correct and very detailed. It's called prompt engineering. And that's what we've done here in Alteryx. We've engineered these two different prompts, making sure they're as descriptive as possible so we get the output we want out the other side. So what we're gonna do is for each review we've got coming in here, we wanna do two things in GPT. Show me that scale and show me the key attributes attributed to that score. So what I'm doing is I'm using a pen field tool here, and I can see I've now got two records for each one of the individual reviews because I'm gonna send up twice to GPT. Heading into my formula tool that I've got here, this is where I create that prompt, which is essentially my instruction plus the feedback fields, which creates my prompt field here in my results grid, and also providing another value that's required for the macro. Going on forward, what I'm also doing is actually appending on a record ID to the data set before I provide it to the ChatGPT macro in one moment's time. Now the benefit of this is, you may have some concerns about sending personally identifiable information to ChatGPT and its cloud service, right? I don't wanna be sending any of my personally identifiable business or client data to that service without my knowing. Now, you don't have to do that. With the power of Alteryx, you get to choose, handpick precisely the bits of information you want to send to the service. And this is where this record ID tool comes into play. Because if I assign a record ID to all of the different items I'm about to send up, chop off the information I don't want to send to the service, have a look what's happening after the macro. I'm joining back to the main data set. I can then append on the information I've kept in my environment, in my business, and it hasn't gone to that cloud service. I've only sent the prompt that I need to send there and joined back the rest of my company's data after the fact. So let's jump in. Here is that ChatGPT macro world first, and all you need to do is download it from the Alteryx public gallery. It's free, you can get hold of it right now. And you then pump in the information you need to put in here. Now, all you need is your API secret key and your organization ID. If you've got an account on OpenAI website, you simply go into your account settings and you can find all that information right there. Simply cut, paste, plate it into the macro we see in the Alteryx screen. And then hook it up to a variety of other fields such as the ID and the prompt, and we're good to go. We simply press run and GPT does the rest. Let's have a look at the other side, shall we? We can see that we've got our response coming out. So here we go, this is review number one. We've got a response of 7. Oh, that's a pretty good score. And the reason for that is it's fast. Clear screen, good size, and fan noise. Interesting. What's this next review? Here we go. 1, keyboard, slow, tacky, value. Oh my God, okay. Maybe we have to take a closer look at that particular laptop or the product and see what's going on there. Maybe we might start to collate all of these reviews together and start to analyze a trend. Are we continuously getting bad reviews on this product, or is this one person who's complaining and the rest are absolutely loving it? Who knows, but this data is gonna show us precisely that picture. So, Hopefully now you can appreciate the power that ChatGPT can have for your business in combination with Alteryx. Rather than logging onto the OpenAI site and typing in one prompt individually, we utilize Alteryx, connect to source, all these disparate data sources you've got across your organization, join them together, cleanse them, standardize them, and then I'm sending a batch prompt to ChatGPT while our world first Alteryx macro to then get the scale that we need for all your business using ChatGPT. If this is interesting, you need to subscribe. We've got plenty of content on this channel with regards to ChatGPT, and there's plenty more coming. Well, if you want to use ChatGPT on your data, of course, you need to be concerned about the quality of your data. We're putting rubbish in, we're going to get rubbish out. So you're going to want to check out this video right here where I talk precisely about how you can manage effectively the data quality within your organization.